Hi friends, welcome back to this React.js Advanced Concept Series. In the last video, I explained custom hooks in React. In this video, I'll be talking about error boundaries in React. Let's get started. Let me show you an example. I have a button, and when I click it, a function runs. Inside this function, let's say I'm fetching some data from an API and storing it in a state. Then I'm logging the name from the first item in the data array to the console. If I click the button, we can see the data is logged. Now, what if the API returns null? Our application will crash. You can see the error here. This happens because we are trying to access properties of null, which is not possible. We can't fix this just by using an optional chaining operator because the data itself is null. To handle this, we can use an if condition like this. Or we can use a try catch block like this. Now if I click the button, the error is caught and the app doesn't crash. Now instead of logging data to the console, let's display it in an unordered list. When we have data, everything works fine. But when the data is null, the application crashes again. For this scenario, we can fix it with an optional chaining operator or a conditional check. But in some cases, fixing errors in the template might not be easy. So what if we don't handle the error here? Again, the application crashes. Now let's try handling it inside the component with a try catch block. Do you think this will work? Let's check. No, it does not work because try catch only handles imperative code like event handlers, API calls, etc. But React's rendering process is declarative. Errors that occur while rendering cannot be caught by try catch. To solve this, we need error boundaries. Let me show you how to create one. Error boundaries must be class components because they use special lifecycle methods get derived state from error and component did catch. To my knowledge, React doesn't provide hooks for handling rendering errors in function components. However, there are libraries like React Error Boundary that offer a hook-based solution. But internally, these still rely on the same class-based error handling mechanism. If I am wrong, feel free to correct me in the comments. Okay, let's create the error boundary component. First, I'll create a constructor and set hasError to false. Next, I will implement getDerivedState from error, which updates the state when an error occurs. Then I will implement componentDidCatch to log the error. Finally, in the render method, I will check if hasError is true. If so, I will display a message. Instead of just showing a message, we could also provide a link to the home page, redirect users to an error page, or handle it differently based on our needs. If no error occurs, the component should render its children normally. This means when everything is working fine, the error boundary won't interfere with rendering. Okay, now let's go to the app component and wrap the failing component inside our error boundary. If I click the button now, the app doesn't crash. Instead, it shows the fallback UI. That's the power of error boundaries. In this example, we place the error boundary at the root level. This means if any part of the app crashes, the entire app won't break, only the fallback UI is shown. But we don't have to use it only at the root level. We can use it around specific sections like forms, lists, or dynamic content to isolate failures. We can also wrap external libraries since they may throw unexpected errors. The best practice is to use multiple error boundaries at different levels rather than wrapping the entire app. Error boundaries only catch errors in rendering phase, lifecycle methods, and constructors of child components. But they do not catch errors in event handlers, async operations like promises, set timeout, API calls, and in server-side rendering. For these cases, we need to use try-catch. Let me show you an example. When I click this button, I am fetching data from an invalid URL. If the response is in OK, I am throwing an error. Otherwise, I print the data. Let's try clicking the button. The app crashes and our error boundary doesn't handle it because this is an async error which error boundaries cannot catch. To fix this, we can use try catch. Like this. Now, if I click the button again, the app doesn't crash anymore. That's all for today. I hope you now understand the importance of error boundaries in React. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave a comment with your questions or topic suggestions. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.